In the last class we have studied some of the defects. Now we will study the remaining defects. Stitches. Rolling of adjacent ends in the warp sheet during the weaving resulting in this type of defects. To avoid it, we need to add good anti-static agent in the size recipe. So to avoid stitches, we have to add size recipe. Good anti-static agent in the size recipe. Employ high warper tension on warp sheet. Use of staggering tappet. Low relative humidity in the shed. Readiness. The grouping of warp ends and fabric producing fine cracks is known as readiness in the fabric. The warp tension should be just adequate. To avoid this, the warp tension should be adequate, not more than necessary. Troughing of the shed as well as early shedding whenever possible helps to reduce readiness. Use of finer reeds also gives a spread of warp ends. Irregular rippiness. It is characterized by the prominence of alternate peaks over a small area on one face of the fabric, which causes card-like appearance. To avoid this, smooth shedding should be done, troughing should be good, use of good emery roller in the take-off mechanism should be used, and increase in warp tension. Weft crack. An open space is formed in the woven fabric due to absence of weft yarn. To avoid this, the anti-crack motion should be perfect. Loose crank arm and loose fitting of the reed. Remove worn out dugbills and heaters in the loose reed mechanism and fast reed mechanism. Correct setting of release finger. This is also present in loose reed mechanism. Proper maintenance of the loom will reduce these kind of defects. Lashing in. It is the length of weft yarn that has been pulled inadvertently into the shed during weaving. Lashing in is length of weft yarn. Weft yarn, extra weft yarn is pulled into the weaving area, and because of that a defect is formed, and this is known as lashing in. To avoid this, proper upkeep of the loom accessories like picker, smooth surface in the box, maintenance of the shuttle eye cutter assembly will reduce this defect. Thick and thin places. When the pick density at any place in the fabric changes from the desired one, a thick place or a thin place is produced depending upon increase or decrease in the pick density. If there is an increase, then it will be thick place. If there is a decrease, then it will be thin place. Proper setting of let off and take up motions and training of the weaver to be quality conscious will help to control these defects. In the interpretation of data, next topic is weft bar. It is a bar running across the width of the fabric, differing in appearance from adjacent normal cloth. To avoid this, controlling of variations in TPI, count, blend, composition, and attending mechanical conditions in the loom will reduce these defects. Proper care should be taken to prevent mixing of filament yarns from different manufacturers, lot, merge number, denier, luster, or number of filaments, etc. Temple marks. These are due to incorrect setting of the temple rollers, poor condition of temples, or incorrect choice of temples. To avoid this, check the alignment and condition of temples at the time of beam gating. Select the proper temple in relation to the cloth to be woven, and reducing the tension in the warp will help reduce this kind of defects. Oil and rust stains. When the yarn or fabric gets contaminated with any lubricant or rust, it gives rise to this kind of defects. To avoid it, proper choice of lubricant is important, training of oilers and operatives, proper cleaning of machines and surroundings, adequate care during transportation of material at various processes are important. Smash. A portion of the fabric
where many broken ends and picks are seen due to shuttle or any waste trapping in the shed, chipping of the shuttle, etc. is termed as smash.
To avoid this, correct timing of shedding and picking are important. Proper shuttle checking should be done. Entanglement of warp end in the heel joint due to warp breakage should be avoided. Thank you.